Welcome to the Aerodynamics course. My name is Doug Hunsaker. I'll be guiding you through this course. And we'll just start off with a definition from Warren Phillips. Aerodynamics is the branch of fluid mechanics concerned with predicting and controlling the forces and moments acting on an aircraft or other object moving through the atmosphere. So we have this world of fluid mechanics. And that would be a prerequisite to this course. Hopefully you have some background in fluids. But a subset of fluids is aerodynamics. And aerodynamics is primarily concerned with the forces and moments on some object moving through a fluid. So if you can imagine that that we have just some three-dimensional object here moving through a fluid, there are forces on this that result from different fluid dynamic principles. One of these is pressure. So if you actually took that object and just put it in a static condition, let's just show this statically sitting in the fluid here. The fluid would exert a pressure on that object. And we can integrate the pressure over the surface of that object, and that is called the buoyant force. So we've got a buoyant force, and that's just the force on any object sitting in a fluid. Now, if the weight of the object is less than the buoyant force or equal to the buoyant force, then that object will float in the fluid due to the integral of the pressure around that object, creating a force that that acts normal to gravity or in the opposite direction of gravity. So it can offset the weight of the object. Now the aerodynamic force comes from the motion of that object through a fluid. So now if we look at that object moving through a fluid, there are two different kinds of forces that act on that. And actually, let's just put this on a different drawing here. So that's a buoyant force. And then here's our object again. And it's now moving through this fluid. There are two different kinds of forces here that act on an object moving through a fluid. We still have a pressure force, but that pressure is going to now depend on the velocity of that object and the shape of that object as it moves through this fluid. So we've got pressure forces, and we also have what are called a shear stress along the surface of the object. So you can imagine that as you get really close to the surface of this object, there's some friction between the fluid and the object itself, and that's what we call a shear stress. So here we've got shear stress, and here we've got pressure. And up here for the buoyant force, we just had pressure. And now these are the aerodynamic. This is the aerodynamic force on that object. So the total force on this object, which we'll write here as a vector, is the aerodynamic force vector plus the buoyant force vector. So that's the total force on this object. Now, we actually like to resolve this force on the object in terms of what we call lift and drag. And so the way we do that is generally, so we've got some direction that this object is moving, and the lift force, so the total force here is some force vector once you integrate all the shear and the pressure forces around this object. But then we can resolve that into two different vectors. One of those is called lift, and one of those is drag. The drag always acts in the same direction as the free stream velocity, and the lift acts perpendicular to the free stream velocity. Okay, so a couple more definitions that we want to talk about here. There are actually two different kinds of aircraft. There are aircraft that derive their, that offset their weight mainly by buoyant forces, and there are aircraft that offset their weight mainly by aerodynamic forces. And those that offset their weight by buoyant force are called aerostats. And you can think of this as stats as kind of the shortening of the word statics. So aerostatics or aerostats. So these are like dirigibles, blimps, even hot air balloons. Now, some of these have mechanisms that control their direction using aerodynamic forces, but the main weight of that aircraft is offset by buoyant forces. And so those fall in that aerostats category. Those that use aerodynamic forces to offset their weight are called aerodynes. And dynes, again, is kind of a shortened word for dynamics. So you can, so you've got aerostats that are where the weight is offset by the statics of the fluid or that buoyant force, and then aerodynes, where the weight is largely offset by aerodynamic forces. And aerodynes are usually divided into two different categories. We've got fixed wing and rotorcraft. So fixed wings are the traditional aircraft that you see, you know, airliners and fighter aircraft, where you have a fixed geometry or the wing is not necessarily moving relative to the rest of the aircraft. So we call that fixed wing. And then rotorcraft would be like helicopters, drones. You see these quad rotors, things that have these rotors on them. And in both cases, though, these aerodynes are creating aerodynamic forces by moving the aircraft or the geometry of the aircraft through the fluid, and that creates a difference in pressure on the upper side of the aircraft compared to the bottom side of the aircraft, and so that produces a lift force that offsets the weight of the aircraft. So those are called aerodynes.